want to quickly thumb through the book without seeing what's written in it to make sure there are words? Go right ahead.
Yes, yes.
Just to prove that it's not blank again like it was last time.
See, it's a real book.
Real book, okay? All right. It's very supportive.
Hello! Woo! This is a storytelling and reading series, and I'm going to start things off tonight. This is A Bird in the Hand. Some people are lucky in love. Others get carsick on their first date and vomit on their date's crotch on the way to the prom.
That's your phone?
Take it!
This is a civilized world, after all. My plan was much more sophisticated. Hey.
This is your punishment. Yeah. This is your punishment.
Guess who's not worried about reading this short story
time? You remember when I borrowed your phone before?
Because we didn't have service?
You f***ed up. You trusted me.
Yeah. You got to keep that ringer on, buddy.
Perfect. My fine feather friend would then spend the evening tightly tucked away.
Here it is.
When I would rescue him, package him up, send him through the campus post office and open it in human thought until my love came for his months to go back and beyond.
Sorry.
look how mad he is.
I will say though, buddy, your hair looks very good.
Thank you all.
Let's get another author up there.
Oh, cute. I wrote a memoir about growing up as a red-headed, freckle-faced Puerto Rican in an Italian-Irish neighborhood in the Bronx.
What is she doing?
Had the perfect butt except me. And that was a problem.
The problem solved, everybody. Somebody swooped in, a good Samaritan.
Yes.
And has prevented the phone from going
off. So Sal, go ahead and undo what she did to your phone. And let's continue.
Jesus, exhausted, in pain, for the third and final time.
It's okay. The next line was long pause.
Ooh, I feel bad back here. We're two stores away in a basement. I feel bad.
He looks like he's about to cry.
I'm worried about him. Is he okay? Maybe we should call him and find out.
It's annoying me as much as you guys. I know, but I don't know what to say. I want to be part of this.
Can you shut it all?
I'm trying.
Yeah, you're part of it.
I'm trying. Okay. It's mine. I'm sorry, I'm ruining your night. I'm an asshole. I'm not trying to do it on purpose.
I don't. Get out of here.
That is brutal.
Oh, it's not over yet, buddy.
You have to read your story next.
I'm sure you've got a room full of people dying to respect
support,
you and your story, yes.
Put your phone on the desk. And hey, buddy, you're just not allowed to touch the phone.
Well, thank you for having me. My name is Sal Vulcano. I'd like to read an excerpt from my book, Silence is Golden. She emerged from her room with a new sense of self, a reason to be. It wasn't long before the curls from her hair fell, however. Time would soon come that you... Oh, my God. This is the worst day of my life. Time would soon come that she'd have to speak to Charles again, and this time she couldn't... It was a June baby that they were hoping for, but the time he had come and her belly was still empty.
She just took your phone.
Thank you. I have a phone call to make.